In 2001, I did not care at all about framerate. All I cared about was the wonder I felt inside the dark corridors of Castle Wolfenstein and the adrenaline rush I got while being under the influence of... Not all of us had Atron XPs or Pentium 3s clocked at 1.4 GHz, coupled with the almighty GeForce 3 Ti500, or the way underrated and amazing Radeon 8500. No, sir! I distinctly remember having a friend with a Duron 1200 coupled with an integrated video card, playing Return to Castle Wolfenstein and Aliens vs Predator 2 at absolutely minimum settings, but still enjoying them like there was no tomorrow. So, was Duron that bad? Let's see, shall we? These are the components that I'm going to use tonight, and I'm starting with the set Duron, clocked at 1.2 GHz, which uses the Morgan core. This CPU was released in 2001 at a price of around $100. Yes, this was its greatest appeal. It was cheap compared to other CPUs from 2001, such as the Athlon 1600 Plus, which had a cost of $160, or the Pentium 3 Tualatin, which had a cost of around $300. The Achilles heel of the Duron was its level 2 cache. It only had 64 kilobytes, compared to 256 or even 512 kilobytes of other CPUs from 2001. And these 64 kilobytes could greatly hinder its performance, especially in games. The motherboard is an Elite Group Computer Systems K7VT-A2 with the mighty VIA KT266A chipset. This is one of those boards that support both DDR and SDR memory. Nice! I'm going to compare the Duron with one of the fastest CPUs from 2001, an Intel Pentium 3S clocked at 1.26 GHz. This right here is a monster. It was marketed as a server CPU, whatever that means, and it has a whopping 512 kilobytes of level 2 cache. Its 2001 price was around $300, so 3 times more expensive than the Duron. The motherboard is a... yeah, proprietary Dell motherboard. Nothing to see here. It supports only SDR memory, but I'm glad it has an AGP slot. I'm going to use 512 SDR memory, clocked at 133 MHz, 512 is a lot for 2001, but I don't want this test to be hindered by the RAM. Talking about hindrances, the video card is a Radeon 9600 XT, released in 2003, a card that will surely release the full potential and latent powers of both CPUs. If you think that Duron 1200 and 9600 XT is an unrealistic scenario for 2003, in 2006 I had an Athlon XP 1700 Plus and a GeForce 6600. As you can see, the main differences between the CPUs are the front side bus speed and the level 2 cache. I'm going to ignore the 66 MHz in frequency because the comparison needs to look good. Thank you for not mentioning this. As usual, synthetic tests first. Super P is a test where we don't see the $200 difference. Of course, none of us is crazy enough to buy computers for using them in Super P or fight over the internet about which CPU is better. Now, for those of you that are still clinging to this benchmark, in Seas of Sandra 2004, the Duron is faster than the Pentium. Fancy that, in CPU arithmetic tests. It's faster both in dry stone, benchmark which emphasizes integer operations, and in whetstone, benchmark which emphasizes floating point performance. The programs on which Seas of Sandra tests are based date back to the 60s, Fortran, Salgol, Pascal and other dinosaurs. In the CPU multimedia tests, the Pentium is faster, just for the floating point operations. Installing 3DMark 2001 took around 1 minute for both of them. 3 seconds difference is nothing. I've used an IDE hard drive all the time, by the way. Installing a GOG game was 15 seconds faster on the Pentium 3, unnoticeable considering it took over 2 minutes for each CPU. The first huge difference is in WinRAR. We're compressing a 320 MB folder with 2000 files. The Pentium is over 2 times faster. I really did not expect this. Look at the differences when compressing this audio file, it's crazy. If any of you have an explanation for this, please let me know. It might even be a "the test was flawed" type of comment. Extracting the archive did not result in such a big difference. The Pentium 3 was not even 20% faster. Moving to 3DMR 2000, the Duron is not as fast as the Pentium. As you can see, the Pentium 3 sits all the time at 99 FPS, while the Duron around 80. The AMD CPU has 5100 points and the Pentium around 9200, almost 80% more points. In 3DMark 2001 SE, the Pentium does not drop under 100 FPS, while the Duron likes to move between 60 and 90. 6300 points for AMD, 8700 points for Intel. I've slowed Unreal to half the speed, to better see the FPS differences. Although the games don't run at 1-on-1 parity, what's on the left is not identical to what's on the right, we can clearly see that the Pentium 3 has a lot more FPS than the Duron, when looking at combat FPS. But here we have parity, and the Pentium 3 seems to have around 50% more FPS. Unreal is a game from 1998, and I was using high settings. The AMD can sustain very high FPS in Quake 3, it stays around 80 FPS all the time. The Pentium pumps 91 FPS, which is the maximum FPS for this game, because it's limited to that value. But Quake 3 has an excellent in-game benchmark, and yeah, the same as in Unreal's case, 50% more FPS for the Pentium 3, 130 FPS compared to 88 for the Duron. Still, 88 is nothing to scoff at. The Duron has half the performance in AMDK2, nothing to say here. Let's see again that price difference. Ah, that's better. Never forget, 3 times more expensive. A classic horror survival from 2001, Cliff Barker's Undying runs bad on both CPUs. The game does not seem to be that optimized. I'm using Direct3D, 20 FPS for the Duron, 30 for the Pentium 3, we still have 50% less FPS with the AMD. But what about the loading times? Well, the Pentium 3 is 2 times faster, which means that the AMD is 2 times slower, 11 seconds compared to 5 seconds for the Pentium 3. Now, let's see a side-by-side comparison to better gauge the differences. 50% less FPS for the Duron. Don't forget guys, the Duron was a low budget CPU, while the Pentium 3 was the best that you can get in 2001. I'm not surprised by these differences. Well, maybe just a little.
We've all been quite worried. Jeremiah is now bedridden. Follow me and I'll show you to his living quarters.
Returning to Castle Wolfenstein would have taken a lot longer on the Duron. The Pentium 3 loaded this multiplayer map on 9 seconds, while the Duron in 19 seconds, twice as much. Load the game, take a quick snack and you're ready. Ready to see the performance of this game, at 800x600, 32-bit and quality settings. 73 FPS for the Pentium 3, 51 FPS for the Duron, 30% slower. Looking at the left footage, we see that the Duron has frequent drops to 30-40. And in a fast-paced multiplayer game, in the heat of the battle, these drops might have been the difference between life and death. The loading time is similar in Zero Sum the Second Encounter, the Pentium is just 2-3 seconds faster. But the frame rate is another difference. The AMD stays at around 20-30 FPS during combat, with the average being 40, while the average for the Pentium 3 is 72 FPS, 80% more performance, that's 80. The Duron cannot keep up with the Radeon 9600, it simply can't, it is what it is, even the Pentium 3 is way slower for this card, but this for another time. What's the verdict? As you can see, this Pentium 3 is way, way faster in gaming. The Duron's 64 KB of level 2 cache are simply not enough for games. The Duron does not have bad performance per se, but we're also using a very powerful video card. Second, the Duron had a cost of $100, while the Pentium had a price of around $300. This has some implications to the dollars per FPS metric. What? The amount of dollars you are willing to pay for each frame. You paid twice more for one frame, if you had the Pentium 3. So, the Duron had a better price per performance ratio. The Pentium 3 would have needed a price of $160 to have the same performance per price ratio as the Duron. The AMD was not a bad CPU. Let's go down memory lane. We're in the holiday season of 2001. You've been a good boy the entire year. I mean, you took out the trash, you did your homework, you did not kick the cat. Wonderful. Santa was gracious and gave you $600 for buying a new computer. For $600, you can buy this AMD computer. Really nice. Duron at 1200 MHz, 256 DDR memory, 40GB hard drive, and the wonderful GeForce 3 Ti-200. Let's build one using the Pentium 3. Yeah, we need to use the integrated video card. If you had the money, Pentium 3 reigned supreme. If you had a tight budget, Duron was amazing.
But Geek, of course the Duron was amazing. You were using a 9600 XT.
So, you want to feel like it's 2001? Ok, let's couple the Duron with a video card that we all had, a GeForce 2 MX400. Yes sir, we have here a 2001 budget gaming PC. Let's go. Before the game, please be aware that I'm using this mouse. I'm letting the ball roll, precision is out the window. We're starting with Quake 3 and 30 FPS during combat, using the same settings as before. This is quite good, not bad at all. Comparing the GeForce 2 with the Radeon 9600, the Radeon has doubled the performance. So, the Duron can sustain more powerful cards than the GeForce 2 MX. In Return to Castle Wolfenstein, the performance is simply awful. Just look at these frames. I was a man of few frames in 2001, but this is not cool. You really need a faster video card to unleash the Duron's performance. But, if we move to 640x480 medium settings, the game moves and feels way better. 50-60 FPS is really something else. 2001 budget gaming, ladies and gentlemen. And then there is Undying, where the performance is not good, again. But don't worry, the Radeon 9600 XT is also not that fast. Look at this. It's something with this game, I can tell you that. Well, was the Duron any good? Absolutely yes. But unfortunately for the late Durons, Athlon XPs became cheaper starting with 2002. But you could still make a buck by going with the Duron. Or you got the Intel budget option, the Celeron. Or maybe not, it's okay. Thank you all for watching. And until next time, give low-end components a chance and be nostalgic.